Celeb Big Brother winner, Courtney Act. Welcome. It is a pleasure to have you.
How long do you think I get to like hold that title?
A long time.
Like, does it ever end?
Well, hasn't someone won since that and no one's saying, oh no, it was Ryan, wasn't it? Yeah. But everyone's still saying Celeb Big Brother winner of this year's you. So hold on to the title, girl.
Somebody on Twitter was like, Courtney and Ryan are the king and queen of, like, the reigning king and queen of Celebrity Big Brother. And then India Willoughby got on there and was like, actually, Sarah would be the queen because Courtney's a...
Shut up.
You're a queen, girl.
I mean, I feel actually, like, well, life for you, especially this year, it's just like, boom. Like,
oh my God, it's been epic.
You've done everything. So the bi life I loved. And can I say that actually, I actually learned a lot with that show, and I think you've done so well at like breaking down stigma of like, you know, gender and sexuality, and what I liked about the bi life is, unlike Love Island, nobody left, because that stressed me every week. The stress of someone leaving, I was like, oh, no. So that's what I really liked. Will you do it again, the bi life?
I hope so. It was so much fun. And it was, the group were really lovely and really sweet. And it was just fun, like, being in Barcelona.
Yeah.
And except I felt a bit ripped off because I was setting everybody up on dates. And then I just go back to my hotel room and just sit there alone, like, oh, that's fun. Everyone's on a date, having fun.
Everyone's falling in love.
Sitting here.
I was going to say,
in the hotel room, in Spain, this is completely unrelated, but the television in the hotel would come on automatically every time you would enter.
Whoa.
And it would have this, like, woman who, like, was reading tarot cards. Like, it was just the default channel, and she'd be, like, reading people's fortunes in Spanish, so I didn't understand it. But then, at 1 a.m, it would be softcore porn. And this one night, the power went out and came back on.
As
a
default?
Woken, as a default. Like,
are you sure?
I was awoken by, like, lesbian porn on the television. I woke up and I was like, why are there women having sex in my hotel room? That was so confusing.
So it was a bit of a blur. Did you like any of the contestants?
Like?
Yeah, like, or would that been, because you've done the show, you could.
I kept a professional
distance. Oh, okay.
You know, in a post-Harvey Weinstein world, the girl has to be. No, but it was funny because, you know, like, normally when you meet someone that you think's hot, like, you put the word on them.
Yeah.
And in this instance, I didn't. And that was kind of, I learnt something, because spending that much time with them, I sort of watched my, like, my feelings wane and wax. And, there was, like, in the beginning, I was like, oh, yeah, he's hot. And then by the end, I was like, yeah, no.
That's how it works on Love Island, isn't it? You walk in and you're like, him.
And then nothing about looks by the end of it, I don't think.
Yeah.
You're living with people, they drive you mad, you can see everything, the true colours very quickly.
They call them like, you have the goggles on when you first see people, don't you? And then they slowly come off, and you're like, oh no, this is not going to work.
Yeah.
The Christmas Eve extravaganza, this sounds amazing. So this is going to be on Channel 4 Christmas Eve.
Yep. Out to Gogglebox.
Yes.
Get ready. You'll be at home with your family and be like, Mum, Dad, let's watch the Channel 4. Wow, what's this? Oh, look at that.
It's Courtney's show.
Yeah.
A lineup. You've got Leona Lewis.
Yes.
You've got Little
Zara
Mix.
Zara Larson. Johnny Peacock. We've got Adore Bianca and Darian from Drag Race.
Yeah.
And it was just, I think my whole life led up to the filming of the special. It was just like the most favorite thing I've ever done. There's like dancing boys in like tuxedos and giant like 8-foot candy canes on wheels and sets and props and songs. And
I feel like I'm more excited about this than Christmas Day.
It's so good.
But you're not gonna like. So what do you do with Little Mix? Because I know you're not gonna do the huge with them. You're not gonna like. You know, it's not just a chat.
We did a little sketch. Because I was inspired by their stripped single cover. Where they're all naked with the words painted on them.
Yeah, which I love, by the way, Pierce, you can pipe down. I thought it was really good,
Someone was, I was doing an interview with someone who was like, yeah, well, you know, the girls have been called this and the girls have been called that. And I'm like, yeah, and then they painted it on their body and like, that's the whole point. And there was a woman who was asked, like, sort of like being a bit like niggly, sort of saying like, oh yeah, well, people have said this. And I was like, did you completely miss the whole feminist aspect of this message?
I thought it was a really powerful thing.
Yeah.
I don't really know why. But then, like, you know, damned if you do, damned if you don't sometimes, isn't it, with them?
Cute.
So, 11 p.m. Channel 4.
Yes, and can I also just say, Leona Lewis is possibly the sweetest human being I've ever met. We did a duet together, and
she's unreal.
She's just, like, so sweet. And then afterwards, she was like, could we like swap emails and like catch up? And I was like, yes, Leona Lewis, we could. So we had dinner last week.
Really?
And the best part is, we'd finished dinner. We were at this vegan restaurant and she was like, oh, I might get something for my dad. And I was like, oh, cool. She's like, oh, let me just see if he's around. And I was like, did your dad drive you to dinner?
Oh.
And he did, and he was waiting outside to pick her up.
That's so sweet.
It was the sweetest thing ever.
She's just very,
he's a good man, Lennox Lewis. I mean, he does so much for his daughter.
No, dad jokes. Pete, come on. Come on, dad jokes.
He's got a dad, and his last name is Lewis, so I presume.
You and Andrew Brady. Your relationship
before Caroline Flack.
Before Caroline, we actually have a little clip of you guys in the bar.
Aww.
Let's just have a look.
You're actually gonna shave your legs in the bath, right? You can shave my feet for me if you want.
Oh. Feet.
Like that.
Aww, you too. Yeah, we'll clap you.
Explain anything to all my.
No, I just, it's amazing because you look great and great.
When you're like locked away in that environment and you don't know what's going on in the outside world, you just don't know. And then you come out and I was like, oh,
yeah.
It was so fun watching it all back. And I watched every episode.
Did you watch every episode back?
Oh my God, it took me so long.
Yeah. Did you do that with Love Island?
No, I just used to do it when I used to do my makeup. I just used to watch it.
But I've not seen it.
None of it.
So good.
I watched like one
episode.
Show.
Yeah.
When my dad came in. It's
tense, mate.
Did you watch your performances back on Strictly?
I actually haven't. AJ's in here every week. Did you watch yours back?
Mine was more I'm a Celebrity. I remember coming out of that.
Yeah.
And never watching it, but with Strictly, the performances that I liked, I watched them.
Watch them back.
10, 20 times each. I was so proud of it. I'm a celeb, I never watch back.
I think it'll be a Christmas Day thing. I'll sit there with a mince pie and just.
You
watch
should
them
make
back.
The entire family watch every one of your performances.
I think they've had enough.
Yeah, then I want to do it.